to mobilize 460% healthcare providers and researchers and policymakers from across 35 countries in Africa. It's a huge effort. It's very stressful. But when you see all of us now under one roof and all of us believe in one vision, that one day, everyone in Africa will have access, proper access, to equitable healthcare solutions. And towards this, vision, we'll all work hard. We will work hard and partner with governments who are sharing the vision, with local governments, with global organizations, with universities and all the stakeholders, even parliament members and policymakers. They have a great role, and we want to fill this gap. That's why we have this meeting today.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Merck Africa Luminary, another valuable milestone of our long-term and strong commitment towards the social and economic development of Africa. Our overall aims are to address social and health challenges and solutions, to improve disease management, early detection and prevention, to build professional healthcare capacity, and to improve access to innovative and equitable healthcare solutions on this continent.
The reason why we are doing this is because Africa is the continent of the future. We believe so. And today already, six of the world's fastest growing economies are in Africa, on the top 15. It is then presenting a tremendous opportunity to develop as a company, to grow our business here in Africa. But most importantly, as a leading science and technology company, and as a highly responsible company, we want to ensure that we contribute to the development of the African countries and the development of their people, and that as many as those African citizens are healthier and more productive as we contribute to transforming their lives through the solutions and through the therapies that we provide here in Africa, in order to contribute also to development and to growth of the economy.
À ma qualité de ministre de la Santé et de l'Hygiène publique, je me réjouis également de la tenue de ce colloque, qui rassemble ici en Abidjan des éminents professeurs et des experts avérés dans la recherche en santé. Il est certain que Merck Luminary donne l'opportunité à nos spécialistes de la santé de partager avec leurs différents homologues venant des 35 pays les résultats obtenus dans leurs pays respectifs, faisant ainsi avancer la réflexion.
C'est un honneur pour moi aujourd'hui d'être devant cette auguste assemblée constituée de décideurs politiques, de chercheurs, fournisseurs de soins de santé, provenant de plus de 25 pays africains, anglophones et francophones, à l'occasion de la troisième conférence de Merck, qui sera également l'occasion de lancer pour la première fois la campagne « Plus qu'une mère pour les pays d'Afrique francophone ». J'ai accepté de répondre à l'invitation de Merck, car ayant œuvré pour la protection des droits de la femme et de la jeune fille, je considère que ces assises constituent une réponse appropriée aux questions de santé de cette catégorie de la population en République centrafricaine, mon pays en particulier, et en Afrique en général. En ma qualité de première dame, je voudrais soutenir l'initiative à la campagne Plus qu'une mère.
Ce projet a pour objectif principal de contribuer au développement social et économique en Afrique de deux façons. Premièrement, en renforçant les capacités des agents de santé et des structures hospitalières. Et deuxièmement, en favorisant des soins de santé de haute qualité et innovants. Mesdames et messieurs, je déclare officiellement ouvert ce troisième colloque Merck Africa Luminary. Je vous remercie. Thank you.
say to you that infertility is not only a problem for limited resources, women or women who cannot afford treatment. It's also a problem for high-level women and educated women. And you will see the story of Joyce now in the video before we tell her how she utilized this story to change the landscape of infertility in Kenya by creating the first policy to regulate ART in sub-Saharan African countries.
First of all, I want to take this opportunity to thank Mark More Than a Mother for coming on board, for coming to start a conversation in Africa that many thought is a taboo, it's a curse, and it cannot be spoken out loudly. And so when I was elected, it's my first time to be elected in Parliament, I met with other female members of Parliament and shared my story with them, and I told them we need to bring a bill. Luckily enough, there was a draft from a previous Parliament, from another member of Parliament called Honorable Millie Odhiambo, so we picked that bill. And we made sure that we championed that bill in Parliament. We made sure that we mobilized even male members of Parliament to support the bill. And for those who are from Kenya, I'm sure you heard about that bill. It was called IVF bill. Now it's called ART bill. And we made sure that bill passed in Parliament. And as we speak right now, we are the first Parliament in Africa to have passed the ART bill at the National Assembly. And it has already gone to Senate, and I'm sure the Senate, because everybody was involved in the beginning, I'm sure there'll be less amendments to make sure that we have a bill that will regulate from, when we say ART, I think all of you here are doctors, you understand what it means, because now it puts on board all the procedures from IVF and any other medical treatment for infertility.
We have in the audience now, we watched the video of Grace and the story, and we have in the video now Grace, can you come please? So she built a fantastic restaurant now. Yes. Are you happy?
Yes, I'm very happy.
Is there? So now the life is different. Life is different now, and everything is.
Maisha,
yes, life is very different now. She's independent.
Yes. It's great.
She said that life is very different for her, and as you can see, she's already looking beautiful, and she. Because Mark More Than a Mother came on board to help her and empower her. Even the problem that she was having of using insulin every day, she no longer uses it. Is that so, Grace? Yes.
So our key message is prevention. Infertility can be prevented, but also cured. So rather than people seeking, first, you know, when you fail to have a child, then people believe you have either been cursed or something wrong has happened. So the first call is to go to the witch doctors. So the first call now should be for people to go to the hospitals so that they can be checked and treated, and then we leave the rest to God.
We are members of the AU, the UN, and we talk about stopping all form of violence against women and children. Stigmatization is a form of violence. Changing our minds and changing our attitudes, especially for us as Africans, how we look at women, how we treat our daughters. It's not just to the men, but to the women as well. As mothers, you want your daughter and your son to go to school. After graduation, you hope that they get married. After marriage, you start asking for your grandchildren. In the absence of that, you either start blaming your daughter or blaming your son-in-law. Am I right or wrong? These are some of the things that we need to change as Africans. We need to change our minds, change our attitudes, how we look at a woman more than a mother.
We had to create the culture shift through awareness and sensitization. And awareness and sensitization meant we needed to form these women into groups, build their capacity, give them information so that they are the change agent in the community to go and tell others that one, you can, both of us can have a problem. If you feel you've got married, you can go to the hospital, both the man and the woman together, so that you can identify who has a problem.
Now we have in the audience as well women from Nigeria. Who is from Nigeria? Empowering these women, but also the future women through awareness, education about infertility, so they know what is their options. And also the government, how to take care of them from the beginning when they have a problem. And encouraging also men to talk about infertility and know that it is not only the problem of women. So how do you feel about this, and what's your opinion?
I believe we'll lead the advocate, or I'm leading the advocate for men to have the courage to come up and say, yes, I have this problem. Because from statistics, 50% of the problem is a male factor. And we have to emphasize, and all the men here today, I want to ask you to please join us to educate our men wherever you come from. Let them know that being infertile doesn't make you less a man.
Je suis très heureuse de représenter la première dame aujourd'hui pour participer à ce panel qui est très important. Le programme Mère plus qu'une mère qui va être lancé dans mon pays est un programme très important. Donc aujourd'hui, pour la Centrafrique, il y a un problème social, culturel. Un vrai problème à ce niveau social, parce que la femme, elle est dévalorisée et culturelle, parce que dans la tête, la femme, c'est la, s'il n'y a pas un enfant dans un couple, c'est la faute de la femme. Donc pour régler ce problème, il faut mettre en place un programme d'information, d'éducation et communication sur les deux personnes publiques cibles. D'abord, auprès des femmes, pour leur dire que si elles n'ont pas eu d'enfants, ce n'est pas de leur faute, il faut chercher les causes pour les rassurer, pour qu'elles puissent faire face à ce problème d'infertilité.
So can we also ask the ACPA and the other women from Côte d'Ivoire to come to the stage? Exactly, that's why we are involving and partnering with government and parliament members to make sure that you see these cases and to live it and to have the experience firsthand, so they can dedicate budget and support for these women and the future women. And the future is bright, because it's like anything else in the past, when non-communicable diseases was not on the agenda of the government, and now it's on the agenda of the government. Infertility will be on the government agenda very soon. It started already. So thank you very much for all of you, all our ministers, all our governments and parliament members for supporting us, because we can create and change landscape of infertility care in Africa. Thank you very much. Thank you, you beautiful ladies. Thank you. We are coming to visit you as well.
What MAC is doing, bringing the government, bringing the practitioners to come together to focus on infertility and to make a cultural change, is very, very helpful. And I said it, and I'll say it again. Having been in practice in infertility for over 35 years in Nigeria, in the US, and in Europe, I have not seen no pharmaceutical company have devoted so much interest, consideration, enthusiasm, followed by action to help the people who are deprived of having children. So I think we all need to give MAC a significant commendation.
Whereas the clinician has the limelight, taking in and continuous contact with the patient, the engine behind that decision and the heart of ART decision making is driven by and rests on the embryologist. And it is this critical element to which Merck relates in terms of providing the training support. First, identifying the institutions which are able to deliver the curriculum within a prescribed period.
Wherever we operate, in every country we operate, we become part of society. We are part of the people through our employees, through the solutions we have, through our customers, through the people we help and the patients we help. And it's our duty as a member of a society not only to take but also to give. We have a duty to do good. And this is what we intend to do and intend to continue doing.